there. In this video, we're gonna talk about one of the most important aspects of UI design, typography. You'll learn how good typography will establish a strong visual hierarchy, build trust in your users, and help to solidify your branding. I'm Elizé, an Adobe XD Enterprise Instructor, and I've been designing apps and websites as a UX UI designer since 2015. I'm also a design speaker and host tons of free events every week. If you have any questions as we go through this video, please feel free to leave it in the comments below and we'll get back to you as soon as possible. If you want more content like this from Career Foundry, go ahead and subscribe and hit the bell icon to be notified of when their new releases come out every week. This video is part of Career Foundry's free UI short course. If you'd like to work along with the lesson plans in this series, go ahead and just click the link in the description below. Now let's dive in with Adobe XD and get into typography. The right typography harmonizes with the other components on the interface. It also kind of invites the user to understand what is their next step and ultimately help them accomplish their goal. The most important characteristics of typography is clarity and readability, which we're going to cover a little bit more in depth. Now let's look at some of the key elements of typography. The first is fonts and typefaces. A typeface is a family of related fonts, while a font refers to the widths, the weights, and the styles that constitute a typeface. For example, Arial is a typeface and Arial Bold is a font. Typographical hierarchy is the process of using sizing, colors, contrast, and alignment to guide the users on what they should pay attention to first. So for example, size. Your headings will be quite large, but your subheadings are gonna be smaller than that and your body text is gonna be even smaller than that, right? Contrast. Like hierarchy, contrast helps you to emphasize which messages and ideas you want the user to pay special attention to. So, for example, if you have a darker, bolder font, users are going to pay more attention to that than, let's say, something like gray, smaller, etc., right? Consistency. Now, this is key if you want to avoid a very cluttered and messy interface, which we all do. It's good to establish a consistent hierarchy for your typography. So all of your headings and all of your body copy stays consistent throughout the experience. Right, white space, also known as negative space. It typically goes unnoticed by the users, but it's pretty vital in establishing hierarchy and also making sure it's an uncluttered interface. Alignment is the process of unifying and composing text, graphics, and images to ensure equal space, sizing, and distance between each element. For example, aligning your text to the right is going to seem really counterintuitive for people who read left to right. Next, we'll look at how we apply the text and these principles to the digital interface with typesetting. UI designers spend a lot of time to compose the text and to adjust the spacing between letters and lines. This art of arranging text is called typesetting. For this exercise, we'll focus on three fundamental techniques that you'll need to typeset your text. The first is kerning, and it's the practice of adjusting the spacing between each character, making it feel really evenly distributed. Tracking is more concerned with the spacing between the words, making sure they don't feel like too close together or too far apart. And leaning is the practice of adjusting the space between the lines of text. Now that we're more familiar with the different typographic building blocks, let's focus on how you actually choose the fonts for your interface. Here are some of the considerations you're going to need to make. First is to reflect on the personality and tone. Think about your chosen app and intended audience. How do you want them to feel when they're interacting with your app? Happy? Serious? What is the tone that you want to achieve? Once you've answered these questions, it'll kind of help to narrow down the interface options and help you to choose a font that really reflects the type of feeling you want your users to have. stick to one typeface. Now, it might be tempting to use a bunch of different types of typefaces, but that is what's gonna make the whole app feel really cluttered. Sticking to one interface type will help to achieve a more cohesive look and feel. Ideally, your chosen typography will have enough range so that you can choose your primary and secondary fonts. Your primary font is going to be used for all of your larger text, like your headings, and your secondary font is going to be used more for buttons as well as your body text. When choosing a font, especially the secondary font, readability is super, super important. Some of the most readable serif fonts are Times New Roman and Georgia. Some of the most readable sans serif fonts are Helvetica, Futura, and Arial. All right, now for the practical part. Let's start putting some of that text into our app screens. We're gonna also wanna create a description that summarizes our app perfectly. So step number one, let's add text into our screens. We're gonna go into the toolbar on the left-hand side. And the third one down is your text tool. Now you can click it in your toolbar or you can use the shortcut T on your keyboard. So I'm gonna select this guy and click into my artboard. From here, I'm gonna put in my heading title. I'm just gonna put in app title for now. And what I can do is start to change some of the attributes of this text. So I'm just double clicking to highlight all of the text. I'm gonna change the font size here. So underneath where it says Helvetica New is the font size. And I'm going to change that to 40. I'm also gonna change the weight over here where it says regular. I'm just gonna go into the drop down and click into bold. Now this is going to be the most eye-catching text on the screen. So from here, I'm actually gonna go back into select. So I can just go into select over here in the toolbar and I'm going to move it so that it's center. Now I know it's center because that pink line straight down the center is letting me know it's a guide for where is the center of the screen. So I'm gonna let go when I see that pink line. Now from here, I'm gonna add the subtext. So I'm gonna go back into the toolbar, click into text, and this time, instead of just clicking into the artboard, I'm gonna make a rectangle. This allows me to set the width constraints for this text area. And I'm just gonna paste in what we call lorem ipsum for now. And it looks like a hodgepodge mess. No worries. No matter how your text defaults, you can again always change it over here in your property inspector in the text section. So from here, I'm gonna change this to a 20 font. And I'm gonna change the weight to regular. And from here, again, I'm gonna go into select mode in my toolbar. And the shortcut for that is V as well. And now I can drag this to where I want it. And I'm just gonna bring this down closer to the buttons. Now you can go back to the original screens and go ahead and use the description that's provided there, or you can create your own description for your app as well. So as you can see, I am using the center alignment here, but you can also change your alignment to be left aligned or right aligned, depending on how you want your text to look. But probably for this screen, we're gonna choose the center alignment. That's what looks best. Now let's go ahead and add our text for our buttons. So I'm gonna go back into the toolbar, select T for text, and I'm going to just click into that button. From here, I'm going to put in sign up and I am going to select V, which is the shortcut for select mode. And I'm just aligning it to be exactly centered into that button. Now I'm going to also, again, make another text over here in the other button. And this is going to be login. Same thing, I'm clicking out. I'm selecting V for the shortcut to get into select mode, and I'm just aligning it so that's perfectly centered. Now, I'm fine with this text size. You can change your text size here again if you want to, so that it feels right and appropriate for the button sizing. Now, you might want to adjust the sizing of your buttons once you start seeing all the text laid out like this. So maybe I would make my button just a tad smaller. Maybe I'm gonna make it about here, and then I'm gonna center that. Same thing with this button. I'm gonna change it to a 60 height. And then I'm just going to drag this whole area up to this top so they're closer together. Now those button sizes look a little bit more appropriate for the screen size. So step number two, choose your font. You can actually use one of the default fonts here in Adobe XD, or you can use a site like Google Fonts or 1001 Fonts to download some of the fonts there. Now, once you've downloaded your fonts, they should be accessible from this little drop down here. And if not, go ahead and just close out Adobe XD and reopen it, and it should appear after that. Now you can choose to have your title text, your subtext, and your button text all in the same font, or you can pair different fonts together. And I highly recommend checking out fontpair.co to see some combinations that work well together. Step number three is typesetting. So once you've selected some text, you can go ahead and change the character spacing here in the property inspector or the line spacing. Now, what you want to do is just play around with this and see what looks balanced to you. Something that I highly recommend doing is making sure that there is enough spacing between the bottom of your longer characters and the tops of your taller characters. So I actually might change this, the line spacing here to 24. There's just a little bit more spacing between each line and it feels like it reads a bit better. You want to find out what works best for your fonts that you're using. Hopefully now you have a better understanding of typography in digital design. Typography is such a crucial part of the UI design process, and now you're just one step closer to becoming a pro. Feel free to experiment with different typefaces and see how that impacts the feeling and the messaging of your app. This was lesson four in Career Foundry's free UI short course. You can sign up via the link in the description below and work along with us. If you've already signed up for this short course and are watching this video in the tutorial pages, go ahead and keep reading the tutorial page. You'll find tons more tips and information below. If you've enjoyed this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to the channel to see more UX UI videos weekly. If you have any questions on interface design or any of the topics that we're covering, please leave them in the comments below and we'll get back to you as soon as possible. Thank you so much for watching and stay tuned for the final video. We are gonna cover color and imagery and all those final touches in our app screen. So we'll see you there and keep up the great work.